Well, folks, this match was a year and a half in the making and probably will never, ever happen again. I certainly encourage you to join us for this history-making event this Sunday exclusively on pay-per-view at the Survivor Series. And I guess I'm Ed Johnson.
Can this guy not wait? Can this guy not read a format? This is not scheduled now.
I'm Ed Johnson. Has challenged Steve Austin. Austin has accepted. Apparently, Ahmed Johnson and Stone Cold will get it on next. We are back, ladies and gentlemen, live on Raw from Hershey Park, Pennsylvania. Ahmed Johnson is in the ring. Earlier, he challenged Stone Cold Steve Austin to a one-on-one matchup. Now, this match was, from what we understand, scheduled to take place a little bit later here tonight. So,
Ahmed just couldn't wait. He came straight out here, and we're still looking for Steve Austin.
Through hellfire and brimstone comes that seven-foot monster, Kane, the brother of The Undertaker.
Well, Ahmed Johnson just couldn't wait for a fight. But if he'd have known this was going to happen, I believe he could have waited just a little bit longer.
Maybe until hell freezes over. We know that Kane's on his way to the Survivor Series to meet Mankind. That pay-per-view spectacular will be absolutely awesome on Sunday. But what's going on here right now?
We never knew he was going to be here. And it certainly wasn't a challenge between Ahmed and Kane.
Ahmed Johnson not backing down from this monster that has dominated each and every body that he has come in front of.
Ahmed Johnson, I think, took a half step back, and that's the farthest he's gone back since he's been in the WWF.
Ahmed Johnson with right hand. Ahmed Johnson knows he's going to defend himself here. This is not a matchup. And the reverse all. Uh-oh. A choke slam.
Good God.
Ahmed Drill with a choke slam. And that's 310 pounds of Ahmed Johnson.
And Kane standing over Ahmed Johnson.
It's going to be a tombstone. This is the Undertaker tombstone pile driver.
Look at Paul Bearer. Paul Bearer saying to Kane, do it again, do it again.
Well, you better do it again if you don't want Ahmed Johnson to get back up. Oh, come on.
Kane, he's going to do it again.
Two tombstone pile drivers.
Who could put him out?
Metal, ladies and gentlemen, you see lying there in the ring was what Mankind used to strike Kane. And Kane went down, but Kane got right back up. Let's take you back to what happened just moments ago. Kane had already delivered a tombstone pile driver to Ahmed Johnson. That was the second one, James.
And then as Mankind came into the ring, he was right next to Paul Bearer. Mankind put the mandible claw on his former manager. And down went Paul Bearer. But Kane saw the action of that. Bam! Turnbuckle bolt, which was not bent until it struck Kane's head. We never thought we'd see Kane go down, JR.
But the 7-foot, 300-plus-pound monster would not stay down long. He was struck right in the face of that piece of metal. The metal was bent, and then watch this. Kane would set up just like his brother, The Undertaker. And certainly Mankind able to get Ahmed Johnson out of the ring. And as we speak, Ahmed Johnson is receiving medical attention. But I tell you, I have never, ever seen this kind of carnage. I've never seen anybody that could, I don't know if anybody can handle Kane.
I don't know if any human being can take Kane. And I'll guarantee you this, as long as he's in the WWF, nobody is safe. Not the Undertaker. Oh, man.
Well, I don't know if we're safe either, because here comes Stone Cold. He was ready to fight Ahmed Johnson. As we said, Ahmed Johnson is receiving medical attention as we speak.
I dare somebody to read a format. I dare somebody to wait their turn tonight. They're out of control.
I tell you what, he is a rattlesnake. You can tell he was in a mood to fight when he got here. I don't think it's gotten any better.
He can run for mayor of Hershey.
I said Ahmed Johnson was going to get his ass whipped, and that's exactly what happened. As far as I'm concerned, he got off light, because Steve Austin would have opened up the real can of whoop-ass and served it to him on a spoon. If Ahmed Johnson can drag his ass back out here, I'm still ready to fight him. But if he ain't, I'll take on anyone in the dressing room. All you got to do is come step through these ropes right here. Somebody come out, because Stone Cold is ready to raise hell.
Well, nobody can say Austin picked them carefully.
He can send anybody, Vince McMahon, anybody.
Toughest SOB in the WWF, and he may be the next Intercontinental
champion.
There's got
to be somebody in that dressing room that's got a set of guts. Then again, maybe they don't.
There's not a lot of frogs back there, because nobody's jumping. Not so far.
Austin wants to warm up, whoop somebody's
butt.
Someone
give me a hot dog and a beer.
Before Survivor Series.
Look at
you.
Well, here comes the Nation. Remember, it was Stone Cold Steve Austin who cost for a room the Intercontinental title at Bad Blood back in October in St. Louis before over 20,000 fans at the Kiel Center.
And also, don't forget, he's given Rocky Maivia the Stone Cold Stunner in the past. But it looks now like Kama is the man who's been elected, so to speak.
Kama, the Supreme Fighting Machine, at 6'8", 300-plus pounds, is coming to fight Stone Cold. Wait a minute. Here comes the Legion of Doom. Austin Animal attacks the Nation. Austin for the Stone. Stone Cold Steve Austin has just stunned this giant Kama right out of his boots, and we got a hell of a fight on the outside.
Kama down. Kama is down from the stunner, and Steve Austin has a smile on his face.
Survivor Series, and we've got us one heck of a fight. It is chaotic here.
And did you see Austin? He said, yeah, let him fight. I did my thing, and I'm going to have a beer.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, whatever you do, don't go away. What's going to happen next? I can tell you this. When we come back on the War Zone,